Hello everyone, I'm Zeffy Davy, and this is my channel. And this is my friend Persephone. We became very great friends over a year ago. And now that I'm in Greece, we have an amazing, amazing time traveling because we like adventures, correct?
We are for sure.
So we decided to leave yesterday from Athens and just got across Evia, the place that it was burned very badly last year. And Persephone had make a fund for the people that were burned and to help them out. So we went and took a couple families and all that. But today we're sitting here in this incredible place that is like in the country, and the energy is so crisp and beautiful and amazing. I mean, so totally different than the city. No matter where you are in the world, of course, if you sit in this incredible place, you know, like in the land, and people have built this incredible hub houses, and people like to live in the land, and the vegetarians and the vegans, and it exists all over the world, as you know. It's not just in America. I'm discovering it even in Greece. So I'm going to ask Persephone just to give us a little bit of a feeling how she feels this week, and what she thinks the energy is about, and where do you think we're going with this energy? All these questions.
First of all, thank you very much for all your words. I totally resonate with what Zeffy said about our meeting and our relationship. It was like, you came in my life for a very, very nice reasons, many, many reasons. I'm very grateful for that.
Me too.
I feel I found my sister, of my sisters, sisters of light, with the same vision, the same purpose in life. And I enjoy very much this trip that we're doing. We have the same, let's say, not craziness, but with a good way, you know.
Craziness. We just allow the spirit to take us there, and we really don't know where we're going. We just know a couple places, and then we stop in places that we discover. There's places that we always wanted to go, and there's a story that I'll tell you once Persephone finish about what happened to me in this trip.
Yes. Amazing. Also for me was very special. So I enjoyed very much. Thank you very much for coming in my life again. In this life.
Thank you, honey.
And also, we are in a very beautiful place. It's a community off-grid, and it's something that this is coming to share, maybe, that I really suggest to people to gather each other and be as families. It's new families, the new communities, that we can share everything together. We can share life, cooking, growing our vegetables. I have this collective life, which is very beautiful because you evolve yourself in many ways. And also it's the opportunity to be closer to nature, to our nature. And because I live in a community for 11 years, not permanently, but I was going just for 3-4 days, and then I was going back to Athens, let's say, in the city. My experience is that saved my life because accelerate my process, accelerate for seeing my brothers and sisters like mirrors, let's say.
And also your spiritual growth.
I mean my spiritual growth.
Yeah, that's amazing. That's the most amazing when you're in a community like that. Like
exactly.
Yours. Yeah.
My spiritual evolution.
Evolution, exactly.
First of all, your heart is open and full of love because you feel this unity and this this energy when you share the same vision. When your soul is vibrating with the same way with other souls that they want to be free.
Exactly.
Free not from the system, but from the system within us, because the system outside, it's the system that we have inside.
Exactly.
And that's why we are going through all this situation, because humanity, collectively but also individually, created this very strong system within. So we manifest it in our outer world. That's why the revolution comes from within.
Exactly.
So it's very good also, not because you open your heart. We have a lot of cats here. Hungry ones.
You because their owner is still sleeping. But it's okay. We'll feed them. There's food. We just don't know where their food is.
But in the communities, in the collectivities, in these kind of families that you choose to be part of, you can see your mirrors. You can observe your projections.
Exactly. Mm?
And this, it's very important to accelerate the spiritual process, your spiritual growth. Because if you're alone, of course, you can evolve yourself. But maybe you need a little bit more time than to have your mirror in front of you and see and observe what you project to others. So for me, a very nice meaning is to organize ourselves and stay together and create these beautiful places, these beautiful energies. It's what humanity needs. Small, small groups, and then we can change the whole world.
Exactly. And this is the energy of the week that the message is coming through, even for me, because I used to live in a community like Sedona, and now I'm in a big city in Athens. But, you know, I'm trying to find my community. I'm trying to find my grounding place like I had in Sedona. And it's been a little bit difficult. I'm going through a death and rebirth and also, you know, missing Sedona a lot. But the ultimate thing is to find new soul people, the community and the family, the soul family, as we say, that you've been with for a very long time. And this is where the energy is going, like discover yourself, but also discover the family, not just your immediate family, but the family all around you, because anybody can be your family, correct? Even a little kitty can be your family. You don't know. You really don't know. But the point is, this is the energy of the week. The energy of the week is that we have to create communities. We have to create community within ourselves also. Because if we cannot make a community within ourselves, like understand our male and female, accept our ancestors that live within us, and go through all this process inside our bodies, there's no way we can create that outside our bodies. So that's the lesson for the week, if you want to call it like that, and the energy. But I have to tell you my experience. What happened is we were coming here. What happened was we stopped in this place for coffee because Persephone was feeling a little bit dizzy. And Persephone, of course, you know, is an ancient goddess name. So I have Persephone goddess here with me. I forgot about that.
Two goddesses.
So she was feeling a little bit dizzy and she said, can we stop for coffee? And normally it's 5 o'clock in the evening and none of us drink coffee after, say, a certain time. So I said, okay, let's stop. But you know, how are you going to fall asleep at night? She goes, I don't know, but I feel I need something. So we stopped in this little town. We had no idea what the name was. We ordered our coffee and the hot chocolate for me. And we went, walked around a little bit to find some envelopes that we needed to have with us. And we asked this kiosk place, what is this place? And what's the name of this place? And he goes, this name of this place is St. John the Roshan. And it's an incredible miracle a saint that we have here in Greece that when the fires happened, they took his
icon.
Yeah, I think so, it was the icon. And went around the little town and the fire stopped. Actually, rain came. So he makes a lot of miracles and really incredible situation. We found out a lot of miracles there. And I can talk all day, but I'm not going to go there. So what happened was we went, light a candle like we do in Greek Orthodox Church. We talked to the priest. We bought some gifts. And then we left. She called her mother to tell her the great news. I called my mother. And guess what she told me? She said when she was 7 to 8 months pregnant, for me, she was pregnant to me. Not, you know, I guess to me is the correct word. I'm not sure. But with me, that's it. She was pregnant with me. She came with a truck and she was sitting in the back of the truck to actually come and, you know, do the offerings that she needed to do for me here and for her, probably the easy birth that she had, which I came out very easily and quickly. So for me, when I was sitting in the church before I found this story, I felt that I was gathering all my energies to actually come back here in Greece. And that was the major confirmation when my mother said that before I was born, she came here as to light the candle and all that. So just follow your life. Just allow the life to take you. Be in the flow. Be a little crazy like we are.
Trust.
Trust. And that's the message. Just allow be with you in your family, also create you out of family. And I'll see you next week. Namaste.
Thank you. Namaste.